We have arrived at the Onze Lieve Vrouwenkerk. I think, Marlijn?
Yes.
Ariela? Ariela, so wonderful to see you. This is great, by the way. I haven't seen everybody for 2 months, and now everybody just walks into the screen. You're the director of Light and Heritage. Where are we, and why is this such an important part of the pilgrim story?
We're at the back of what used to be the Vrouwenkerk. I say used to be, there used to be an enormous church here. But as you can see, only a bit of the choir is left. And it was one of the three parish churches in Leiden. It was used by the Walloon community. Except for the pilgrims, the Leiden also had an enormous refugee community who were French or Northern Belgium, Walloons. And they had their church here. And some of them even went with the pilgrims to America. So it was the poorest church. And that's why they gave it to the immigrants. It was a fairly poor neighborhood.
Mm-hmm.
And the Walloons mostly stayed here. Some of them also went to America later to found New Amsterdam. But because it's such an important pilgrim place, we have commissioned a few reconstructions of pilgrim places as they would have looked at the time of the pilgrims.
Because this is one of the main projects of Heritage Leiden this year.
This is one of our main
projects. Digitally reconstruct some of the places that are no longer with us in full glory.
Yes.
And this is basically, we're going to see three of those places today, and this is going to be the first one.
Yes.
Why is it important to reconstruct these places?
Because we have a lot of documents. They are all written in 17th century script. They're difficult to read. We have transcripted them. You can read them on the database. But if you want to have a real feel of what the city the pilgrims lived in looked like, you really want to see the buildings as they were. There are a lot of buildings which are still the same, like City Hall, but there are an awful lot of places which have changed. And we wanted to give people the feeling, this is the city of the pilgrims.
Yeah. And this is still going on, the reconstructions, as we
yes,
speak?
Yes, as we speak.
I mean, there's still scholars and technicians working on it?
Yeah. It's a combination between historians, building historians, and 3D experts. And they find all the information they can about the building. We have some pictures, but also some charts where you can see the actual sizes, the footprint.
Yeah.
And from all that information, they built the building.
They kind of rebuilt.
Yeah, they can rebuild the building. I think Theo will tell you a bit more
yes,
about
so
it
we'll
later.
Yes, we'll meet Theo, your colleague in this project later on. So when will people be able to see this online? And
The first reconstruction is online now. That's the Breestraat. That will Theo explain to you later. I think today you'll get a sneak preview of this one. The Begijnhofkerk is also nearly finished, so I think over the next few months, watch this space.
Wonderful, wonderful. And a bit more about, is there anything more you can tell us about this
yes.
place?
Yes, I said some of the pilgrims went with, some of the Walloons went with the pilgrims. There is one marriage in our records between Hester Mailleux and Thomas Cook. They went on the Mayflower. And Hester Mailleux's nephew, Philippe de Lannoy, he was baptized here and he went on the fortune, followed his aunt basically. And he is an ancestor of Franklin Delano Roosevelt. That's where the Delano comes from. Delanois, Delano.
Delanois.
Yeah.
She has Wallonia roots.
Yeah.
Marlijn, can we show some...
I already did.
Oh, we already did.
Yes,
the people at home already
excellent.
saw this footage. Ariela, thank you so much for now. I think we will meet each other at Heritage Leiden again.
See you later.
You'll tell us something more about the Pilgrim Archives. So see you in a bit.
Okay, see you. Enjoy.